Dear friends, welcome to NSR Electrical. Today we know about transformer part 1. This is the index of transformer part 1. First one is introduction, second working principle, third types of transformer, fourth core and winding introduction, and the fifth one is EMF equation. This is just basic purpose. In next upcoming videos I will explain briefly about transformer introduction. Transformer is passive electrical device that transfers electrical energy from one circuit to another through the process of electromagnetic induction. It is most commonly used to step up or step down AC voltage levels between the circuits. Working principle. The working principle of transformer is mutual induction between two or more windings or coils allows for electrical energy transferred between the circuits. Types of transformer. Instrument transformer, step up and step down transformer, single phase and three phase transformer, power transformer, distribution transformer. Instrument transformers are two types, current transformer and potential transformer. Instrument transformer or isolation transformer. Current transformer is used for measuring high currents and also for the protection. For example, if its ratio is 500:1 amp, CT ratio is 500:1 amp, it means CT has an output of 1 ampere when the input current is 500 amps on the primary side. Potential or voltage transformer, PT or VT. Main function of PT is to step down the voltage level to safe limit or value. For example, we have to measure 11 kV. It is critical to measure 11 kV. So the PT is step down the 11 kV to 110 volts. The primary of PT is 11 kV and secondary output voltage is 110 volts. Step up and step down transformer is categorized on the basis of number of turns in the primary and secondary windings and the induced EMF. Here secondary voltage is greater than primary voltage, it is called step up transformer, and secondary voltage is less than primary voltage, it is called step down transformer. Power transformers are used in the transmission networks of higher voltages like 400 kV to 200 kV, 110 kV, 66 kV, 33 kV. Distribution transformers used in 11 kV, 6.6 kV, 33.3 kV, 400 volts and 230 volts. This is a single phase transformer. Here primary winding is denoted as NP, secondary winding denoted as NS, and primary voltage is VP, secondary voltage is VS. Primary current is IP, secondary current is IS. This is the transformer core and magnetic flux. If we give the input voltage on primary side, the primary winding is created the magnetic flux through transformer core. According to Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, the main flux direction is perpendicular to current direction. Here flux passes the transformer core and this main flux cuts the secondary coil winding and here produce the induced EMF. This is the three phase transformer windings. The connection of primary and secondary windings can be done by various combinations shown below. Primary winding, secondary winding, primary star to star, delta to delta, star to delta, delta to star. Seventh one is auto transformer. It has only one winding. We give the input voltage to A and B points and we take the output voltage to C and B points. Eighth one classification is
outdoor type and indoor type transformers. Ninth one is oil cooled and dry type transformer. The oil in the transformer is used for cooling purpose, also insulating the winding purpose, and protecting from moisture. Core type transformer. The primary and secondary windings are wound outside the surrounding the core ring. Shell type transformer. The primary and secondary windings pass inside the steel magnetic circuit. Here we see the diagrams of core type and shell type transformer. Transformer core. It provides the magnetic path to the channel flux. Core is laminated to reduce eddy current losses. The eddy current losses cause energy to be lost from the transformer as they heat up the core. Transformer winding. Windings are the conductors wrapped in the various forms like helical, disc, cylindrical, crossover, who generates MMF that is carried by the core to other windings for having the different level of voltages. In next upcoming videos, I will briefly explain the how to design the core and how to design the winding. This is just an introduction part for basic purpose. Next we see the transformer winding types. First one is cylindrical winding. These windings are layered type and uses rectangular or round conductor. Cylindrical windings are low voltage windings used up to 6.6 kV for kVA up to 600 to 750 and current rating between 10 to 600 amps. Second one is helical windings. Helical windings, low voltage, high capability transformers where current is higher, at the same time winding turns are lesser. The output of transformer varies from 160 to 1000 kVA, from 0.23 to 15 kV. Third one is crossover windings. Crossover windings are used for high voltage windings for small transformers. The windings are divided into number of coils in order to reduce voltage between adjacent layers. The voltages between adjacent coils should not be more than 800 to 1000 volts. Fourth one is disc and continuous disc winding, primarily used for high capacity transformer. The windings consist of a number of flat coils or discs in series or parallel. Fifth one is sandwich type winding. Allow easy control over the reactance and nearest to coils are together on the same magnetic axis. The greater is the proportion of mutual flux and the less is the leakage flux. Next we see the EMF equation. This is the most important equation for the transformers. Here we know the by using this equation we know the induced EMF voltage and number of turns, cross sectional area of core, and flux density. When the sinusoidal voltage is applied to the primary winding of a transformer, alternating flux sets up in the iron core of the transformer. This sinusoidal flux links with both primary and secondary windings. The rate of change of flux with respect to the time is derived mathematically called EMF equation. ERMS equal to 4.44 into F into N into A into BM. Here ERMS is induced EMF voltage and F is supply frequency, N is number of turns on primary or secondary windings, A is cross sectional area of core, and BM is maximum value of flux density. Next, transformer part 2. We will learn energy losses, transformer parts, types of cooling, sizing calculation, turns ratio calculation. Thank you friends, please subscribe, like and share.